Hello, I am Senior Pastor G.W. Gore at the Word of God Christian Ministries. And if you have your Bibles, turn with me to Proverbs chapter 31, verse 9. And I will be reading from the New King James Version. And it reads as follows. It says, "Open your mouth, judge righteously, and plead the cause of the poor and the needy." Plead the cause of the poor and needy. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. The grass withers and the flowers fade, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Listen, it's important as believers, if you are a witness to a racial situation where you can defend someone, it is important that you speak up and speak out. Open your mouth and say something to defend righteousness and truth against today's oppressors. It's important that we fight for those who are being attacked or where innocent men and women are being killed at the hands of sinful people or at the hands of a racial act against those who are helpless to even defend themselves. As we have seen on TV many times, children, young men, unarmed young men and women. It's important that we stand up and use our mouth to silence the wicked and racist agenda, you know. And I'm talking to the community other than mine. Do not allow it to stand, not at all. And I understand sometimes what hinders men from standing up for what is right in the eyesight of God is really this: fear. They're afraid to speak up because it might cost them something. They do not want to really get involved because they value the peace that they're used to and the privilege they have come to rely on more than the constant brutality and the killing of innocent people. They rather turn an eye to that. They don't want to go against the popular or the political correctness. Amen. Some of them are, you know, intimidated by others holding a strong ungodly opinion, and that is that one race is superior to another. But God created us in his image, so all of us are really created equal. You cannot do anything good being silent and allowing the evil of racism to continue. White or black, it is your duty before God and men, before God and men, to reject and warn other sinners of the wickedness of racism. You have to speak up. You have to speak out, and you have to say something. Because if you allow wickedness of racism to take place, you are not the solution, but the problem. In today's society, with free speech and with social media, it is our duty, your duty, to take your platform, no matter how big, no matter how small it may be, and speak for righteousness, speak the truth against the injustice of racism. So today, as we encounter our text, let us consider the thought, speaking out against injustice. Speak out against injustice. So you're saying, Pastor, how do I speak out against injustice? It's right in the text. First, we must speak for the destitute. Speak for the destitute. Not, which means those without the basics of life. No voice, no opportunity, and no hope. We as believers, and I'm talking to those not just in my community, but other races, white, black, Indian, Latino, whatever your race may be, it's important that we speak for those who have no voice. Speak up for those who have no opportunity. It's important that we be a voice to the voiceless. Proverbs chapter 31, verse 9, right in the text, it says, open your mouth, judge righteously. Open your mouth and judge righteously. Listen, Christian leaders of all races, talking to all of us, have a tremendous responsibility and obligation to God's word and to God's will. And that is to speak up for those who cannot speak up for themselves. Remember, the Bible says, "To much is given, much is required." Christian leaders must not indulge or become slaves to the passion of their flesh, like money, power, or even privilege. If they do, they set a poor example for those who are leading, or those who they are leading, and they render themselves unqualified for the task or their duties. Listen, God's warning is really unmistakable in this text. Immorality, in intoxication of racism, will ruin any leader and render them really ineffective to lead God's people. I know sometimes it's easier to take the way out that is more politically correct. Some of us don't speak up because we are from a race that has received privilege through many years, and we feel that it's not our place. But the society that we're living in today, it is the responsibility of every man, every believer in Jesus Christ, every Christian must speak up against racism. We must speak up against the sinful system of racism and injustice that oppress our brothers and our sisters. How traumatic that both of these are really common in leadership of the society and really around the world that we live in today. whether in government, whether in business, or the church, you know, people really are blown away when you tell them that the most segregated time in our country, or really in the world, is on Sunday morning. It's important as leaders that we are trusted with the responsibility of the life and the future of God's people. And we cannot continue to allow racism to rise as it has today. I went to an event of one of our young members, Takiya McFarland, and she led a young group of people, and I was so proud and really so excited to see young people, not only black, but white, coming together genuinely in love and respect for one another to speak on racism and injustice. They spoke out. Their message was clear. And it was a blessing to be a part of seeing our young people who are tomorrow's leaders to stand for what in God's eyesight is right. It's important to see that, because as leaders, in future leaders, their decisions affect all who are under them. They are our future congressmen, our future representative, our future corporate leaders, our future business and local leaders. So they must devote the full measure of their strength and attention to their duties. And the one that they're dealing with now is racism and injustice. They must do everything possible, and I told them to stay strong physically and mentally. And speaking to our leaders today, it's so important to speak out and eliminate the sinful and injustice of racism. If the Christian pulpit remains silent on this issue of racism, I believe in my heart the blood would be on the hands of those who are leading God's people. A Christian revival would not take place where there's hate, where there's indifference, where there is division, and where racism resides. And the scripture in the Bible is clear that racism is sinful. We cannot be Christians and call ourselves believers, no matter if you're white or black, if you condone and accept racism or racist acts, or you're covering yourself in Christianity, but still are committing racist acts towards your brother. So while some are unchurched and they are non-believers in Jesus Christ, they, as Americans, are still spreading hate. People of faith, we as Christians, we as believers on both sides must draw a line and use this opportunity that is long coming to bring peace and love and understanding. Scripture says we must obey God rather than men. Acts chapter 5, verse 29 says we must not lose our witness or testimony in a world that needs the message of God, of the cross, more than ever. We must speak on the repentance of racism. We must lead our brothers and sisters out of this system of racism and show them that they must repent and turn to Christ, because Christ is the only answer to the disease of racism that plague our country today. This is why we must continue to speak out, speak up against racism. Listen, secondly, we must not only speak up and speak out against destitute, but we must speak out for the poor and the needy. When we are speaking of the poor and the needy, it's those who are being oppressed unjustly, that are not given the same opportunities, not because of their education, not because of their character, but they are denied the same paths as others because of the color of their skin. Right in the text, Proverbs chapter 31, verse 9, it says at the latter part of the text, it says, "And plead the cause of the poor and the needy." The goal is to speak. The goal is to speak so that they get justice, that the poor and the needy receive justice and receive opportunities that are allowed not just by some, but it should be given to all. Not to speak, to be heard. We must break the silence, but we should not speak to because it's trendy. We should not speak out because we want to be seen or glorified in any way. But we need to speak because we need to break the silence on both sides. Children and families we serve, we need to make sure that they have hopes and they have dreams and they fulfill their destiny that God has for them. And I'm talking to our political leaders, I'm talking to our local leaders, our corporate leaders, our business, our teachers, our mothers, our fathers, on both sides. Because it's not just a white and black issue. It's an injustice issue. We are called to use what we have to serve the poor and the needy. This is what Jesus did for us. He not only lived for us, Christ died for us as well. He defended us and still defends us in our sinful state. He has called us to plead for those who cannot plead for themselves, because he did the same for us. Christ did. Christ spoke up for us. He still continues to be our intercessor even today as I speak. And he calls us to stand up for others. And I'm talking to the white and the black, to every race. Martin said, our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter, about things that matter. We are doing to, you know, we are to make sure that we are doing God's will, because it's important that we stand for those who can't for themselves. And the question is this, as you listen to this message, what are you doing? What are you doing to defend the rights of those who can't defend themselves? What are you doing for those who have died innocently at the hands of a racist perpetrator? What have you done? When you have seen time and time again of unarmed black men being shot down in the streets, what have you done? What have you done when you've seen the injustice, not only in our government, but also in our corporate world, where the opportunities and the hopes are oppressed, while others may be built up, while others are torn down, not because the content of their character, of their skills, or their talents, but because of their skin color? What have you done? What have you done? What are you doing to speak up for what you know is right and true in the eyes of God? This is why we speak up for those who cannot speak for themselves. We speak because they have no power. We speak up because we have some. I know there are some of you who sharply may disagree with this, but the greatest example of those who cannot speak for themselves are those who are oppressed. It is our duty as Christians, as believers, black and white, we are to defend the defenseless. Not because it's easy, not because it is simple or friendly or fun or popular. Instead, we do it because we have been brought from darkness into light by the grace and the mercy of Jesus Christ. Listen, it is so easy to remain routine while all this is going on around us. It's easy to remain silent when your privilege is not being affected, when your hopes and your opportunities and what it is that bring peace to you is not being affected, while your brother of another color is being trampled upon, while your Christian brother is struggling just to survive, just to live day to day without being pulled over, without being harassed, without being racial profiled. You cannot remain silent, even when we know from God's word that it's wrong to do so. You can't say, I love God, and you love him that you never seen him, but then you can't love the one that you see every day. How can you call yourself a Christian or a believer? We know that we are called on not to overlook the needs or look the other way. Rather, we are called to speak up for the powerless. So those in power today need to hear from us, not just sometimes, but all the time. They need to hear from us on a daily basis, day and night. We need to speak up and speak out for those who cry out and not being heard. For those children that are locked in cages, we need to speak out. For those brothers and sisters that are being trafficked, human trafficked, we need to speak out. For those who are being denied opportunities, those who are being mass incarcerated because of the color of their skin, we need to speak out. For those who are living a life of disparity, a life of hopelessness, we need to speak out. Speaking out and speaking up from the depths of our faith and our commitment to God, His desire for justice, not for some, but for all. The law shouldn't be any different from one race to another. God desires for justice for all, not just for those who are in power or those who have money, but for justice for all, we should speak out. It's important that we lift our voices. It's important that we speak out, speak up, not just in the streets or in the protests, but on our jobs, we need to speak out. In our schools, we need to speak out. In our neighborhoods, we need to speak out against injustice. Anytime that we see, hear, or be around anything that is unjust, we should speak up and speak out. Speak up and speak out. I'm Senior Pastor G.W. Gore, the Word of God, Christian Ministries. And until next time, God bless.
Everybody in the building, everybody got a hand in the air. Everybody in the building, everybody got a hand in the air. What's up, y'all? DJ Favor here. Wow. We just want to give you the information, right? We want to feed your soul so that you can grow and become something righteous, something sanctified, set apart, not conforming to this world, but transformed by the renewing of your mind. And so the way we give it is not to make you jump up and down and run around the church and shout. And it's not pretty. It's not eloquent. It's not entertaining. It's straightforward. Information doesn't have emotion attached to it. God's word is good for reproof, reproach, instruction, direction, guidance. Right? Those things don't make you feel good all the time. Right? I mean, the word of God should make you feel good because there are promises, there are things said that there's love, there's peace, there's joy. So it should make you feel good, but we're not. That's the word on its own. I shouldn't have to dress it up. Pastor shouldn't have to dress it up. And we don't. We don't play any games. We're about education. And so, speak up, speak out, say something. It's sensationally simple. Saving, selfless, These are the things that the saved, those who have salvation, should be seeking to do. Speaking up when it's time to speak up. If nobody speaks up, we should. If nobody speaks out, we should. If nobody gets up, gets out, and does anything, we should. Even if it costs you your life. I'm not preaching, but that was a good word. And I'm here to play music. We want to praise out. But let me say first that if you want to become a member of our church, you want to join our fellowship, you can drop us an email at thewordofgodcm@gmail.com. You can leave a message. We can hit us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, YouTube. These videos are on YouTube. You can leave a comment. And if you want to give, if you want to support our church, you can do so on our website, twogcm.com. We have a giving portal. And we thank you for your generosity. We thank you for your obedience to God. Those of you who are giving your tithes on the website, amen. And we thank you for tuning in. And we thank you for allowing us into your homes, into your hearts, into your families, into your circle. We don't take it for granted. We appreciate it. But let's get into this.
Sure. Yes, I believe.
Yes, I believe.
It belongs to me.
It belongs to
Simple
me.
Word, believe it, say. I shall have.
I shall have.
What I decree.
What I decree.
Yes, I believe. Whatever God has decreed to you,
speak into the atmosphere.
Lay your hands on yourself this time. I shall have what I decree. Yes, I
I never go alone.
I never go alone.
feet to my heart, Jesus.
Is it? stand because I truly been blessed. I stand because he first loved me.
Oh, I
love him because he gives me victory. Is there anybody here who loves the Lord like I do? Tell me now.
Stand up.
Stand up.
Is there anybody here who loves the Lord like I do? Why don't you
stand?
Yeah.